Good morning from day 19. Last night when we got to this site, we thought that it would be a great idea after 28 miles. Turns out, after we went to bed, that we were camping in a beaver dam. And as soon as we got in bed, we heard multiple beavers grunting, dragging things,
splashing
in the water,
arguing about where they put their sticks.
One beaver was telling the other beaver, don't put that on there, put this one here. And it was just like loud guinea pig grunts all night. That had us rattled at first and then giggling, but they did eventually retire for the night at about 1 a.m. So we didn't get the best sleep, and we're both very tired, but it looks like we'll have some great places to take some breaks today along Silver Lake. So yeah, when you get to the dam on trail, there's also a beaver dam. And so this is where we were camping, and literally this is where the beavers were working last night. Just right next to us, you could see the little beaver chomps. You can see right there, they were working on some goodies. On all these trees, there's some bark. There's a big old tree over there that they actually had a couple of them fall. So you can see them working on their dams. So it was quite comical to just, they were unbothered. And obviously if we would have known, we wouldn't have camped here. But by the time we got here, it was dark. We couldn't really see anything, so. Lesson learned. Check for beavers. Brr. Oh, that's cold. We are at, we made it to Silverwood Lake. We're at the picnic area. The water looks so blue and clear, except it's very cold. So I don't think we'll be swimming today. It's a little chilly, but it's very, very pretty. Very pretty. We are at camp. It is early. It is like 5:20, which means we have like hours to just sit around and lounge and eat and talk and get to know my passenger here, Mr. Pimple, who is just swelling with joy that we get McDonald's tomorrow. But anyway, so we're at camp. We're about six and a quarter miles outside of Cajon Pass, which means that we could get some McDonald's tomorrow and hop into the gas station if we have any resupply needs. And we're both very, like, I have not craved McDonald's like in years, but we have been just talking all day about the Egg McMuffins and the hash browns and the Coca-Cola and all the good stuff we're gonna get. So we're gonna enjoy this kind of early day, which is funny because 5 o'clock isn't super early, but we're just gonna enjoy it and then just kind of hop, skip, and fly on into Cajon Pass tomorrow and get some yummy snacks. And then we'll be headed towards Wrightwood. So yeah, that is good night, goodbye, good day from day 19. Okay, bye. Good morning. Today is day 20. We are very hungry this morning and hoping that McDonald's will cure that. It's a little chilly this morning. But it was a beautiful, peaceful night of sleep compared to the night before. So we're much happier to not be intruding on any beaver activity. But yeah, so we're just gonna cruise in. And after that, we have quite a long water carry out of Cajon Pass. So just trying to snag some water from the inner, from Cajon Pass, and then off we're gonna go. But right now, our sights are set on Mickey D's. There it is. I see the arches. Okay, so after eating two McMuffins, some hash browns, some orange juice, and some Coke, we are ready for our 23-mile dry section with all climbing. So this section from here to Wrightwood, there's only one water source, and it is at the top of a 20-mile climb. So we are happy to carry water because our bags are nearly empty, because we only have a day's worth of food to get us through till tomorrow, so we can Nero into Wrightwood. Our goal is to just get as close to the water as we can, because it's another 22 and a half miles. We're not exactly sure if we're gonna make those miles because it is about 10 o'clock, and we'll just see. But our bellies are full, we are happy, and we are ready to get to Wrightwood. See the first. So it's very dark in here, and I hear rats. Actually, it's not that dark once you're in it, but I still hear rats. Do you hear the rats?
Those aren't rats, they're bats.
I want to see one. Water caches are so good. Thank you to those, the trail group that put a bunch of water out, because I was just crying about how thirsty I was, and now I got to refill up my liter of water that I had drank down because I was so thirsty. Well, it is about 3:30 or something. We're about 20 miles into the day. We are like 8 miles from the top of this climb, 7 miles from a tent site, and 9.5 miles to water. I have a little over 2 liters, and Corey has 2 liters. So in theory, we're thinking 7 miles to the campsite, and then that will give us, like, what did I say to town?
7 plus 2.
Yeah, and then we'll have like a short Nero into town tomorrow. So our feet are starting to get a little achy. This climb, you'll climb around the side of a mountain, and then for the next 5 miles, you can just see it climbing around the next mountain. And then when you get there, you can see it climbing around the next mountain. And it's just steep enough to be uncomfortable. And it's, like I said, a 21 or 22 mile climb, and we have about, I don't know, 9 miles to water. So, we're tired. We're hot. It's very hot. But at least we're getting to dry out our tent and my sleeping bag because it got very condensated last night. Must have been breathing heavy. But, whew, I bet we're ready. Well, I'm ready for town tomorrow. I'm going to take some happy posts to our feet. And then we have to go up there. Alright, so we are about seven some miles away from the road into Heightwood. Excuse me. Today was brutal. It was all climb, no water. Thank God for the water cache. And the climbing was just like, we're still not exactly to the top. We still have just a few more feet to the top of this climb, but it is going to be cold and windy tonight, and whew, this is going to be a good night in day 20. I'm glad tomorrow is a town day.